Now we are going to discuss about the chromosome size. Chromosomes are generally studied and measured during mitotic metaphase when they are very thick, quite short and well spread in the cell. Longest metaphase chromosomes are found in trillium, which is 32 micron long. The giant chromosomes found in diptera are permanently in pre-metaphase stage, so it is easily visible in the interphase nucleus. Plants have longer chromosomes than animals. Species having lower chromosomes number have longer chromosomes. Among plant, dicots in general have shorter chromosomes. Today, we are going to focus on chromosome morphology only. In mitotic metaphase chromosome, the following structural features can be seen under the light microscope. Chromatid, centromere, telomere, secondary constriction and satellite, and lastly chromomere. Each metaphase chromosome appears to be longitudinally divided into two identical parts, each of which is known as chromatid. The two chromatids of a chromosome appear to be held together closely at a point called centromere. The two chromatids of a chromosome separate from each other during mitotic anaphase or during anaphase 2 of meiosis and move to the opposite poles. As a consequence, each chromosome is now represented by a single chromatid during telophase. The DNA present in each such chromosome replicates during the synthesis phase of interphase to produce an identical copy of itself, so that during prophase and metaphase, each chromosome is made up of two chromatids. Since the two chromatids making up a chromosome are produced through replication of a single chromatid, they are referred to as sister chromatids. In contrast, the chromatids of homologous chromosomes are known as non-sister chromatids. Under light microscope, centromere generally appears as a constriction, a narrowed region in the chromosomes. Hence, it is termed as a primary constriction. Centromeric region do not take up any stain and they appear as gaps since the region adjacent to centromeres are composed of heterochromatin. During cell division, spindle fibers attach to centromeres. As a result, centromeres are the first parts of the chromosome to be seen moving towards the opposite poles during anaphase. Therefore, it appears as if the anaphase chromosome movement is due to the centromeres of chromosomes. Hence, they are also known as kinetochores. Each chromosome is divided into two transverse parts by its centromere. These parts are called arms. In most cases, one arm of chromosome is longer than the other, hence they are termed as long arm and a short arm. The short arm is usually represented by the letter small p from the French word petite means small, and the long arm is denoted by q. As an example, long arm of chromosome 2 can be written simply as 2q. Chromosomes may be divided into four classes on the basis of the position of their centromeres. These are metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric and telocentric. Metacentric chromosomes. In such chromosome, the centromere is located in the center of the chromosome, that is centromere is median, so that the two arms of such chromosome are equal and arm ratio is 1. Metacentric chromosomes appeared V-like shaped during anaphase. Submetacentric chromosome. In most chromosomes, the centromere is located on one side of the central point, that is the centromere is submedian. Such chromosomes appeared either similar to capital V or small j during anaphase. In this chromosome, centromeres are located close to one end of the chromosome, that is they are subterminal. Acrocentric chromosomes may appear either small j or rod shaped during anaphase. Telocentric chromosomes are occasionally in some chromosomes, the centromere appears to be located at one end of the chromosomes. Such centromeres are called terminal, and the chromosomes having them are known as telocentric chromosomes. These appears are rod shaped during anaphase, and in most species one chromosome has a single centromere. Such chromosomes are termed as monocentric. But in some species such as Drosophilla, each chromosome has more than one centromere. Such chromosomes are called polycentric. In both monocentric and polycentric chromosome, the centromeric property is confined to one or definite points of the chromosomes, so that such chromosomes are referred to as localized. Most homopteran and hemipteran insects, the centromeric activity is non-localized and spread over the entire chromosome length. Such centromeres are known as diffuse centromeres. The two sister chromatids are only held together in the centromeric region due to adhesion provided by cohesion complex. The cohesion complex is a glue. Core of cohesion complex is a heterodimer of SMC. SMC stands for structural maintenance of chromosome. These are the proteins, and these proteins SCC1P is a component of a cohesin complex. This protein is released from the sister chromatids to allow their separation at anaphase. This complex is formed during S phase. Now we need to know about an important part of chromosome, which is satellite DNA or sat DNA. Centromeres contain highly repetitive DNA called satellite DNA or sat DNA, as this class of DNA forms one or more minor bands distinct from the rest of the chromosomal DNA, which is called main band DNA, as it forms the major band under cesium chloride density gradient ultracentrifugation. Sat DNA is highly repetitive. In calf, more than 1 million copies per genome may be present, and repetitive sequence may be 6 to few hundred nucleotide long. In many species, sat DNA consists of only one sequence, while in other more than one distinct sequences are found, such as Drosophilla has three different sequences of seven nucleotides. The two ends of a chromosome are known as telomeres. Telomeres are highly stable and they do not fuse or unite with telomeres of other chromosomes. It is generally accepted that structural integrity and individuality of chromosomes is maintained due to the telomere. In some chromosomes, a second constriction, in addition to that due to centromere, is also present. This additional constriction is known as secondary constriction. The chromosome region distal to the secondary constriction, that is the region between the secondary constriction and the nearest telomere, is known as satellite. Therefore, chromosomes having secondary constrictions are called satellite chromosomes or sat chromosome. It may be noted that sat DNA is not related to the sat chromosome. Sat DNA is present in the centromeric region of all chromosomes. Human somatic cells have 10 sat chromosomes. Nucleolus is always associated with the secondary constrictions. Therefore, secondary constrictions are also called nucleolus organizer regions, and sat chromosomes are often called nucleolus organizer chromosomes. NOR of each sat chromosome contains several hundred copies of the gene coding for ribosomal RNA. Chromomere. In some species, that is maize, amphibia, chromosomes during the first prophase of meiosis, more particularly during pachytene, show small beads-like structure called chromomeres. Chromomeres are mostly visible in the dipterian giant salivary gland chromosomes as dark staining bands. This is all about basic chromosome morphology. In our next video, we will know more about it. If you have any suggestions, queries, please leave a comment below, and please do not forget to share and subscribe. Thank you for your patience.